Hello, and welcome to this video presentation. My name is Paul Brett. I'm a Senior Software Support Analyst supporting the Transformation Extender product from IBM. The topic for this video is using ITX with SQLite via ODBC and JDBC. Feel free to reach out to me on popular social media channels at PaulBrettIBM. In this practical demonstration, I install, configure, and run an SQLite database and connect to it from the DB browser for SQLite package, as well as Eclipse and, of course, ITX. First, I download and extract all the required files. Then, I run the DB browser for SQLite package to create an initial database, table, and data rows. Then I'll create a 64-bit ODBC entry and verify connectivity with Design Studio tools, specifically Database Interface Designer. I will then also connect the Eclipse database perspective to the instance to allow easy admin. Finally, I'll connect an ITX map via JDBC to retrieve data. I'll start this demonstration on my Windows laptop, where you can see I have downloaded the SQLite DLL for Win64, which has arrived as a zip file. Links for all my downloads can be found in the description for this video on YouTube. As you can see, I've already extracted this zip to the directory c:\database, and it contains two files, SQLite3.def and SQLite3.dll. Also in this directory, you will find a few more files, where I've extracted the zip for DB browser for SQLite. I've downloaded the SQLite JDBC driver .jar, and we'll move that later, and also the SQLite ODBC package, which I have also installed. So let's use the DB browser now to create our first database. So here we have DB browser for SQLite.exe. I'm going to run that. I'm going to click the New Database button, and I'm going to create the file in the c:\database directory and call this db1.db. I'm going to create my first table, and it's going to be called test1. Let's add one of the fields. The field name is going to be name. The type is going to be text. And now I'm going to add another field, and I'm going to put in the field as age, and this is going to be an integer. So if I click OK, this table has been created. Now I can start to populate this table with some data. I'm going to do it in the Execute SQL tab. With my statement entered, I can click on the Run button here. And you can see here that the query executed successfully, showing that I've inserted one row of data. Let's put a double minus sign in there to make that a comment, and then select the data from the table. When I execute, you can see here my results. I have one row in the table. So that's my first database created and my first table inside it. Not particularly special, but good enough for our needs moving forward. I'm going to close the DB browser for now, and then we'll move on to the next part of the demonstration. Next, let's create an ODBC entry for my SQLite database. I'm going to fire up the ODBC applet, and in the System DSN tab, I'm going to click Add, and from the list of drivers, I'm going to choose SQLite ODBC driver. Now, this is only here because I've already executed this SQLite ODBC w64.exe package. If you don't see the driver listed here, it's because you haven't run this. Okay, data source name, I'm going to call this local SQLite, and the database name, rather than typing manually, I'm going to click the browse button, navigate to my c:\database directory, and then click on the db1.db database. The database name has been filled in, and we don't need to do anything else for now. So there we go. We have SQLite, my SQLite 3 ODBC database driver, and I can access that from the database interface designer of ITX in the next step. Here we have my project directory, and apart from a backup zip file I have here, you can see it's empty. So let's start my project. I'm going to fire up the database interface designer. I'm using version 10.1.2 for this. And from the file menu, I'm going to choose new. From the database, I'm going to right click and choose new. I'm going to call this database test underscore ODBC. The adapter I'm going to use is ODBC. The data source I'm going to use is the one we just created, local SQLite. And we don't need to put anything in security, user ID or password, because they're just not used. Here I have my test ODBC database. I'm going to save this file as it is right now. Let's call it database underscore queryfile1.mdq, the default. Okay, let's create a query. From new, I choose query 1. And then I put in my query. I have my query in, I click OK, and then expand, we have query 1. If I right click query 1, I can generate a type tree. I'm going to call my type tree query underscore test 1 to show that it's a query based type tree and the table I'm querying is test 1. Everything else can remain the same and I click the OK button. Command completed successfully, which is good, and if we get that window out of the way, we can see that the columns that have been brought in are age and name, which is exactly what we created and as I expected. Hit close here, and now I'm going to save the file one more time and close the database interface designer. Next step, now that I have my query file and my type tree, is to create a map source file to actually query the data. Okay, here we are in the Design Studio. I'm going to right click and choose New Extender Project. I'm not going to use the default location, but instead I'm going to tell it the location where I have my current type trees defined. So if I expand my project, you can see that I have a type tree here, query test 1. And here under miscellaneous, as you can see, we have my maps.zip backup. And under database files, we have my MDQ file. Let's create a map source file. New map source. I'm going to call it test.mms. Within my map source file, I'm going to create a new map called test underscore ODBC. And within this map, I'm going to create a new input card. Card name in 1. Type tree I'm going to use is the type tree that was generated from the query. The object is going to be dbSelect. I'm going to change the source from file to database. And then in the database query files section, I'm going to point to my MDQ file. It loads in the database. There's only one in there, so it loads that one in as the default. And there's only one query, so that's come up as the default. I'm going to add in a minus T for tracing. I'm also going to turn on backup so that I get a copy of the data as a file. And this will enable me to look at the data that's coming in. Now I click OK. This map is ready to run. So I save, build and run. If I go to my Explorer window, you can see my map source file here, my compiled map here, and here's my backup file. And if I right-click and open this with UltraEdit, we see the data that's come in, Paul, and then a column delimiter, and then 52. So this is using the ODBC adapter to retrieve data from an SQLite database. Let's move on to the next step. This next step is optional, but I'm going to connect the database development perspective to my SQLite instance. So over here on the Perspectives button, I'm going to click on Database Development. If you don't see that, you can click this small button here instead to add it, and you will find it there. The first time you use it, you'll need to do this, but for subsequent times it should be here as a shortcut. So I'm going to switch to Database Development and right-click on Database Connections and choose New. From the list of databases, I'm going to click SQLite. For drivers, I'm going to click this button next to the driver definitions box. Then I click on the SQLite JDBC driver, and it says it's unable to locate a jar. From the jar list, I'm going to remove the existing one and add a new one. Now this is the one that I downloaded, and earlier I copied it to the ITX directory. So if I go into my ITX installation under extjar, you will note that I've got the SQLite JDBC driver.jar file here. It's important to copy in here for the maps to use later, but for now I'm going to also use it to reference it from the database development perspective. I need to pick a new driver name, and for the connection URL I need to point to the specific database. So I believe that's that screen ready to go. If we click the test connection button, ping succeeded, and let's click finish, and you'll notice we have a local SQLite entry here now. And if we right click, we can choose open SQL scrapbook, and this now can become our editor for putting in general queries as we're testing the database. Select star from test 1 and I press Ctrl Alt X to execute. The statement has executed and my results have come down here in text. I can also have them in table form by clicking on this button to display results in either text mode or table form. The result 1 tab will show us our data. So that's the database development perspective connected via JDBC. The next step is to connect our map via JDBC. For that, let's close the SQL scrapbook. We won't save our query here and we'll disconnect from the database. And then finally switch back to the Transformation Extender development perspective. Before making adjustments to my map source file, I'm going to create a quick new type tree. From type tree, I'm going to click New Type Tree. Put it in the SQLite project folder, my type tree name, generic.mtt. Root object is root and we have no types under it. Let's add one now. I'm going to create a type called text item. Currently this is a category. Let's change it to an item. And this type tree is basically finished. I'm going to analyze structure and logic and then finally save the file. So there's my generic type tree, which I shall be using in a moment. Opening the map source file, we have our map test underscore ODBC. Let's create a new map called test underscore JDBC. In the outline view, this map appears, currently not executable because it has no cards. Let's add an output card. Type tree is going to be generic.mtt. The object within it is going to be my text item. And we're going to be writing to a file called output.txt. Okay, for this map we're going to be using a get rule to get the data, but this could just as easily have been an input card. So our rule is to get from the JDBC adapter. My URL matches the connection string that I put during the creation of the JDBC entry in the database development perspective. I'm turning on verbose tracing. AS0 and QTY star are required. LSN0 as well. And finally, I have my query, select star from test 1. I've got last error message on the end there just to clean up and catch anything that goes wrong. If I save, build and run this map, you will see that the map has completed successfully, which it would do even if there was a failure with this get because I haven't wrapped it in a valid. But we can just double click on output to see the results and we can see there that we do have an exception. It says there is no table called test 1. I made a small mistake in my rule and I need to change the name of the database that I'm loading. Let's try again, save, build and run. Let's open output.txt and as you can see the data pool 52 has been retrieved using JDBC. That is the end of this demonstration. I've extracted the SQLite database files, created a database, created an ODBC entry. I've connected via the ODBC driver entry with the database interface designer and then created a map that queried the database. I also created a JDBC entry for the database development perspective and finally retrieved data in a map using the JDBC driver. I want to thank you for taking the time to watch my video presentation today. If you found the content interesting and informative, hit that like button. Perhaps leave a comment. Consider subscribing to my YouTube channel as I release content such as this on a regular basis. Feel free to reach out to me on popular social media channels at Paul Brett IBM. Thank you.